Zyra, well, guess what? Wild Turtle has a get out of jail free card for his support by picking Kalista, expecting the Ashe MF lane. Battlefrost can face tank and arrow and get thrown back out.
Turtle cannot face tank and arrow, though.
No, he can. He's got a dodge. And Smoothie's up 100 over Biofrost. So the Golden, look at that. Contracts. He's going to get a first blood assist to Smoothie. Gets the assassination.
Patience pays off for Cloud9 there. He can quickly take care of this Drake. Oh, mid lane arrow.
Gonna try to help Jensen.
Yeah, you know, throw one out there. Jensen's still going for it.
Well, the mini shark, but now the E is gone. Shen to come help out on this one. Jensen taking a lot of damage, but there comes everybody else. Cloud Drake picked up. Sven has to flash away from Smoothie joining this one. And now Bjergsen is running for dear life. Impact gonna land the taunt. There's the rest of the damage. 2-0 to Cloud9 to start out the game. And they're not done yet. Hunter in the mix he goes. Smoothie goes down 2-1. Finally gets an equalizing kill. Good job by TSM's top half of the map. Turns it a bit around.
Like we said, though,
they still have a decent gold lead. It's gonna be on Hunter instead. Shen comes in.
All right, onto the isolated Maokai. Hunter's got no one around him. It's minimum 15 seconds till any TSM shows up.
He's pretty free.
Yeah, I don't see how you get away with this one. He's got flash available. He's trying to get over the wall. Not gonna get the chance to. The final bit of damage comes through. Impact with the kill credit. Now Bjergsen. Oh, found out by Contracts. Exhaust be damned. The solo kill for C9's rookie jungler takes out Bjergsen, and he wants more. He's got that fight for more Danes, and Svenskeren running away.
Exactly. He had
farther back. Sneaky once again. Just he's sitting in the mid lane. This time he does catch out Bjergsen. Plenty of damage there, forcing the flash out. Sees him giving up control of the mid lane. Hanzo does TP in, though. He finds Smoothie.
Oh!
There's the damage out from Biofrost, and they've answered back. The red-haired support goes down. And now Sneaky running, running, running. Over the wall he goes, and suddenly everyone's there along with him. Know-how. Double kill for Biofrost. Nicely done. TSM makes 3-4.
That's that counter dive we're talking about for TSM. The SFC9 are coming up the river.
TSM have enough health. Jensen, who's he gonna find on this one? Are they gonna look for Biofrost? They're gonna get the fish onto him. Here comes the assassination. Hit. One goes down. There's a shutdown. 1,000, 2,000 health left on there. And here comes the attack. And it's gonna go to Svenskeren amidst the random spikes coming through. Another kill comes through actually for Jensen. Takes out Wild Total. Contracts in the mix. A shutdown in for the Maokai, but it's already been a double kill in for Jensen's mid laner here. Hans are now stuck in a bit of a bad situation. 2v2 overall. He goes direct side near him. And it's a triple kill actually coming through. Jensen refuses to go down. Four members of TSM dead.
And Sven's scared. And a bunch of extra gold here. Sven gonna cut him off though.
Got in the back line. The quick stun goes back at a Biofrost. Training the one for one. Sneaky goes down. One more shot, I'll do it. It's bullet time to take him out. And Smoothie now has to run for dear life. Sven does have flash. And
comparing those two. Yes, if it ends at just those kills for a poor Baron. Oh, here we go.
It's Biofrost. Brother does have ulti, pulls him right in. Jensen assassinates absolutely nothing as he gets pulled into the ether. Now the re-engage. Biofrost still up, but why are they focus firing the Zyra? Contracts goes down for the over-aggression. Now Impact locked up, gonna get dropped as well. The random means a double kill for Wild Turtle, and another turret falls.
This Cloud9 comp is not a team-fighting comp. What are you doing? Team for Jensen, they're still very threatening.
Impact wants in on this one, bit of damage. Here comes Contracts! And there goes Wild Turtle flashing away. Can't get out in time as suddenly Vilefrost in front of the team lands a two-man route into the knockup. Contracts finds more from across the map. Downtown Sneaky helps him get the kill. A double for Contracts as he runs for dear life. Maw pops, he's gonna be okay. Impact still tanking the front side, but Hanser finds the flank, does take out Contracts. 2-for-1 so far, C9's lead. Impact still taking the front line, but how far can he really go? Has the flash, jumps the wall. Grump coming for another bite, and Hanser still in the chase, finds the knockback, another stun in for Bjergsen, makes it 2-for-2, and TSM answer equally.
Whoa, very, very interesting.
Twice, you can see how much he heals at any given time, and the attempt now is on to Baron. Bjergsen and Turtle dropped below half HP, and this Baron is not dying fast. Biofrost getting away with a sliver of health. That's Leander's helping a little bit for you, burning down, but still. Damage coming through for Sneaky Force and the flash of the Sven Skirt, and it still stops the Baron. Meanwhile, the base is being sieged. So, yeah, minus a kill kind of sucks. And in fact, another one comes through. No, that's the Zyra callout. Biofrost did actually finally die. Looks like Smoothie was able to get into that one. So, it's a 1-for-1 in kills. And now here comes the re engage. Channeled onto Sneaky. The chase and a turtle. Force the flash away. Bjergsen is low. And actually, looks like the ulti was canceled anyway by Rek'Sai and Maokai. So, he's not part of that fight after all. And Impact. Slowly running away. This 2-on-2 is one that Jensen did not want to be a part of.
Oh, good interrupt. Taunt there from Impact slowed down. Ah, better fish.
Yeah, nicely done. But still, they're trying to wear him down. It's two tanks versus one. And if there's a satchel plant, he's just gone.
Them off. Again, though, right back at the scene of the crime.
Arrow hits Biofrost. Guess what? Wild Turtle can ult if he needs to. Not going to happen just yet. Contract fitting the wings. Haunt going to lock him up. 6,000 HP on Baron, and the Ren stacks drop, so it's a re-engage. Double stun! Contract! Oh, the catch by the Q from the Maokai, but look at the bullet time! Smoothie just eviscerates the back line, gets a double kill on the entire lane, and now there's a bit more to be done. Svenskar and low and HP with five members of C9 here to take that kill, and he gets into the portal, does jump into the Baron Pit, still running out of HP as Haunzer dies after Guardian Angel. 5 versus 2 on the map, and the health bars total about 300 HP, so TSM have nothing to do right now as C9 starts the Baron.
What an amazing flank there from Smoothie. Completely annihilates the backline of TSM with that bullet time, and that means that Svenskeren's gonna have to sneak around here if he wants to try and steal Baron. Not gonna happen, and he's gonna lose GA, and he's going to die after.
And Contract secures the Baron. It was a formality at that point, but that makes it 4 unanswered kills now, plus the Baron picked up, and C9.
I would just brace
him. Not to die anymore.
Feeling, yeah.
He's not gonna get the chance, but there's gonna be a knockup anyway here. Impact gets the taunt. He doesn't really matter. 5, Elder Dragon and Baron buff. Still on for a little while longer. They are good at sieging right now. This turret down to 2/3.
Contracts does get stunned. That's going to be an inhibitor going down there for Cloud9. Bullet time!
Zonya's out of Bjergsen. Still gets caught by the shark! And that's the first shutdown. Contracts gets in. Wants a bit more. Wild Turtle running for dear life. Actually, a kill comes through, but another trade in. That's 3 for 1 so far. Cloud9 in complete control. Wild Turtle and Svenskeren have to somehow stand against the 4-man army of Cloud9. 2 inhibitors already down. Into the bot lane they go. Drop portal to help. And they've got to pull off a minor miracle here. Now comes the attempt for the first turret. That's going to get dropped down. There goes Svenskar into the front line with a turret at a sliver of HP, but that's the kill coming through anyway for Sneaky. His first, second of the game, I should say, as Wild Turtle is running and running and running and not doing enough damage to the Nexus is next to fall, and Cloud9 are going to take the first game win of the 2017 North American LCS season. But of course, we play best of 3. There's still a chance to fire back.
Exactly. This series is not over. By no means here is TSM done. We get to see another game at least here in this best of 3. And man, that was an extremely exciting way to start out. And it does not look fair even to opponents. Something to keep in mind, you don't even have to wait till you're level 6. Level 3 power spike on Katarina.
See, right now it's just a bunch of lane pressure. Smoothie has to be so incredibly respectful of the damage output they can have here.
Into that. Ooh, let's see, mid lane actually, Bjergsen goes in.
A lot of damage there. Jensen does have ulti available. Exhaust is on. He's going to land. There's the ulti. It's enough damage. The Q lands and he takes it home.
Back to back. Down over and over. Nautilus is a so strong early game.
Monster's already burned ult for the region. Now it's going to be the kick out of the wall and Contracts make it 2-0. Infect says, hey, ult's down. He's low. Come up.
Oh, does land the Varus ult.
Biofrost has flash. The chain stuns come in. There he gets over the wall. The flash Q is going to connect once again. Contracts is 3-0, 100% kill share, and out he goes over the blast plane.
Sven's going
for
the steal!
He wants it, not gonna get it. Contracts kicks him out, and now Sven is on the run. Nice flash to get the stun for Smoothie, and who else? But Contracts gets the last hit, 4-0, 5 if you count. There was a battle going on, so him missing a summoner now means the fight into the bot lane. Smoothie's ult is down, the damage is gonna come through, they are gonna make it pay off. Turtle flashing into the turret, just like he always used to. Gets one picked up, Sneaky could be next. The damage is there, Haunts are under the turret, now forced to run, and thankfully for him, the pillar blocks the hook. Impact can't secure it, flashes, but doesn't land the shot on Turtle.
Contracts is coming down the jungle as well.
He knows
Turtle is definitely dead, so he's just trying to lead him away from his teammates. TSM scrambling to get out.
And Svenskeren in a world of hurt, couple more shots, jumps over the wall with the plant. Who's gonna be there? Who's gonna find it? The shark is running away. There's minions now.
I'm trying to decide. I think you give it to the Lee Sin. Don't die. Yeah, don't die to the mid laner.
It's curious because.
All right, meanwhile, Sneaky does land another Varus ultimate onto Haunzer and closes in for some damage.
Nice stun's gonna land right there. This could be everything he needs. He's not gonna get enough damage. Nicely done, Sneaky. He has to take down on Haunzer.
Ultimate, Biofrost is coming through.
Oh, he's dead.
Okay,
goodbye.
Three people is gonna be pretty good.
Take some one flash.
On the other side, they're not too worried.
Turtle in a bad world right now. CC's gonna be chained back and forth. He flashes away. One more auto, gets the crit. 30% chance and it lands. Sneaky now gonna run for dear life.
He's got no flash.
Pops the passive on Biofrost. A bit of a late ulti for Smoothie. I don't know if it was on cooldown or what, but doesn't save his teammate. Now he's gonna be next. And two quick kills picked up the roam for TSM, saving the lives.
Exactly, enough kills for TSM. They're trying to get back into it. Bjergsen!
Jensen versus Bjergsen, exhaust trade, and that's gonna be the kill picked up. Hex Shrinker does get actually blown through, doesn't even matter. Send the knockup onto the satchel plant, and that looked weird. And Contracts flew the other way, I'm pretty sure is what happened.
I feel like we were behind, and they fast forward or something.
Continue the push forward. Contracts finds a friend. Hello, Bjergsen, kick into the wall. Q, Exhaust is in to buy a bit of time. And gets the follow anyway. Yeah, Exhaust timed out. The rest of the damage was there. Goodbye to Bjergsen. Exhaust call from behind, and you feel like you're pent up behind your own turret. They're going for a play here, though. Looks for the damage in the contract silence. Then now the invulnerability in effect, and Wild Turtle gonna run out of HP pretty fast. Sneaky gets the snipe out of that one. Svensker running away. Biofrost low as well. Contracts gonna get body blocked away.
So low cooldown is a bit more castery. Can get poke damage.
Here comes the difficulty. Impact gonna go for the immediate stun, and Bjergsen just popped immediately. Impact a little bit too tanky. Now the exhaust is on. It means Hawks has got to run away. Be careful, Impact. A couple more hits will do it, and they're trying to go back and forth, dancing for the damage output that they need. Impact will bite off more than he can chew. In fact, his Hawks are taking a bite out of him. And now the chase in, the stun, the flat scare, and the rotation. Yeah, that's TP down. So 5 minute cooldown here for Hawker. Stun and a Hawker as well. Here comes the attempt to steal. Who's it going to be? Nice kick out. He flashes. He gets Svensker and steals the Baron. Now the fight is on. Yes, they'll get the kill, but that is so worth it in every possible way for TSM.
TSM need a kite now. They got the Baron for only one death.
Stun's going to land. Hook, good flash away by Hawker. The Merc Treads helping to save his life on that. That was a quarter second timing.
Oh, and they're turning on Smoothie.
No Wolf for Smoothie. That's going to be enough damage. No, he's going to flash over the wall. Quick Zonius from Bjergsen tanks up Jensen. Zolzi, the damage there on the backside. And TSM maybe shouldn't have gone for the 5v4. Two kills picked up. One of them go to contracts. And now it's a 5v2 on the map.
Numbered, and Cloud9 just reversed everything there. They're going to be the ones that actually take down the inhibitor, get the extra kills, they get the extra gold.
Hunter, there's the kick. Here comes Smoothie. Here comes Jensen over the blast cone as well, and they're going to land that stun. Ash Arrow's going to land. That's Jensen locked out for 4 seconds or more. Smoothie going to try to help, but it's going to come in time. Exhaust on Hunter slows him down. The damage is there. Jensen gets the kill credit. Thanks for Lanamicon. Makes it a little bit easier.
Really good move. Here we go for a turret siege. Cloud9 now.
Well, Frost locked on the fight for now. Here comes Svensker. Gets a knockup on a Jensen. How many are going to get invulnerable from Smoothie? Looks like just the front line here, the three of them. He's going to kite back. Stun's going to land back on a Smoothie. They're focused on the support. Didn't go well last time. And they can't quite reach Jensen to the back. The fight continues. Guardian Angel pops. The redemption heal going to be nice for C9. And it's a one kill pickup so far as Contracts has fallen. It's going to be Hanser up next. And it looks like Svensker loses his life as well. The tanky Trundle just barely running
they're
away.
Shooting it.
Guardian Angel down. It's up to Bjergsen to try to carry the fight. It's Wild Turtle diving forward. Hit the same for Biofrost, picking up absolutely everybody. And it's going to be Impact, the last one to fall. He will go down a double for the new AD carry. 4-2 advantage.
Definitely another good tool that they're using. And Bjergsen has to pick his opportunities to go in.
For a bit there, Impact, of course, very tanky. Arrow's going to hit Jensen. Now it's up for Smoothie to keep them alive. Ulti's going to tag onto four. They caught Biofrost. Down goes a TSM support. Hook into the back line. Bjergsen's got to be careful on this one. Pops the ulti. A double for Jensen. Redemption. Now it's three for him. Impact still alive in the front line. Refuses to go down. It's a hat trick. And a double kill for Sneaky.
Clean team fight there from Cloud9. And Contracts got a massive kick all the way through the entire team as well. Plus the high priority execution. And that should be Cloud9 moving up into the base and finishing off the series here. Inhibitor's going to go first. Minions will have to catch up later, but man, what a stark difference from that turret dive.
Absolutely. So it's all she wrote now for this one. The 2-0 is all but secured. This one a little bit faster than the previous and a little bit, just a bit more one-sided than game one here. Cloud9, this time off the backs of Contracts with the insane early game on Lee Sin, 2-0 over TSM.
That Cloud9 hype that was coming from a lot of the scrims and a lot of the analysts.
In a noise hands on one side with the Ringer, and on Froggen's side on the other hand for Echo Fox with that LeBlanc.
Yeah, but we do see both teams playing to their strengths. We talked about the solo laners for Echo Fox Q, but we'll talk about that in a moment here because this is Akkadian, the rookie, trying
nice
to make a play.
Going in, Ryu does get a great block, but it's not enough. Still not tough, and there's first blood for Rek'Sai.
What is it with rookies? Teleport
has to get himself back to the line.
But they're trying to sniff this out because it's a repeat game.
Oh,
from Akkadian.
I love this. Ryu now going to get locked up again. No, the chain not enough. There's going to be a second. Akkadian does it again.
But Inori, he was on the side, and he's going to throw
it. Oh, ton of buffle. That's going to hurt Inori.
Very aggressive, but Inori trying to punish.
Yeah, another tunnel buffer. Inori can chase here. Ryu looking for something. No ulti, gonna lock it down. W's there for the snare. Inori looking to follow in. Leaps in, but Froggen's gonna try and turn around. Akkadian stands his ground and fights him, but Inori is gonna leap back in. And now Froggen, where can he go? Arrow forced to fight. Gate flashes after him. Froggen took out Inori on the other side, but Arrow is looking to go down. Keith able to take him out. And now Ryu's gonna try and run away. Froggen, can he keep it going? Needs to move forward, but no.
A little bit there.
Ooh, might get caught here. Oh no, he's got the pink ward. He's gonna bait him, and now Inori gonna get locked down. Teleport's gonna be committed here. Gate's actually looking for Adrian down the bottom side. Scoops him up, but Keith knocked up by a bubble at the end. Now TP down for P1. Gate will take out Adrian, but Ryu's down here as well to take down Keith. Arrow still fighting away as best he can, and Gate has to run for it. Zig and Looper have joined the party though, and Inori trying to get some damage back. Looper is gonna get crushed down. There's a double kill for Ryu. Arcadian still trying to fight it out, but Froggen goes in. Killed arrows to Inori as Arcadian takes it down. Now Ryu trying to get his way out to safety. Froggen a little low as Gate's pissing one out, but there's a double kill for Zig. Froggen needs to keep
the
running.
W.
Gets locked down. That should be enough, and there's the ace for Phoenix One.
And now it's equal in kills. Six. If that's enough, then it'll be worth it. Here comes the Looper teleport, and they're using the Mimic.
Didn't ulti as well. Dragon does go over. P1, are they going to lose anything here? Zig straight to the front lines. Locks down Looper. Last bullet from Keith's not bad. Varus ulti missing from Arrow as Arcadian's kind of got a flank hook. Lands in onto Zig, and now Arcadian's on the other side. Look for Arrow. Froggen dives in, but he gets exhausted. Nice. That's going to be him taken down as Ryu manages to get it. Ulti's going to knock up Adrian. He dives down as Arrow goes down as well. Ryu now caught up. Blast code's very nice. And now he's under the safety of his turret. Fox are gonna
caster. I totally understand that, but oh, hold on.
Oh, that looks like bad news, Bears. Little too much there for Froggen.
Instantly deleted. Taking a play top.
Power could be problem. Zig does leap onto Looper. Now Inori's gonna follow in with a snare. Looper does go back to his turret. He's gonna ulti one back in, but Inori's not in turret range. Zig is just tanking it forever, and Looper cannot lift it at all. That's not a good news, but Zig, he gets the kill, and Inori gets out.
Yeah, had to use the W, but it drops to Inori. No problem there. Now there's pressure on the top side and the bottom side.
And you. Ryu here as well, ready to lock him down. Froggen's gonna dash his way out. Inori's found him, and Froggen has to get his way out. There's a flash follow, but the chain has landed. Gate's here as well. Everyone's coming through, and now they're gonna turn around. Inori gonna get himself locked down, but he will escape. Redemption pop from Vitavector, healing is Ryu. Maybe get himself out of waves there. No, it's okay. A bit of extra movement speed there as Arrow does take down the gym.
And you saw as they were trying to make that play, Zig chases Looper down the lane. No teleport for you. No getting into that fight.
Uh-oh, Adrian though popped up there. Fox with another kill back. Arcadian with the Hydra takes one out.
Exactly what he needed to do there. He got that pick. The flash out of Arrow.
Better flash Arrow. Oh, Looper almost gets a blast gun out to safety, but Fox, I think, straight onto Baron.
Yeah, they are actually going to go and attempt this Baron there. There's a control ward right there that sees Froggen.
Hi! Uh-oh!
I guess they're just baiting the teleport out.
Well, they got it. Zig gonna flash in though. Gate eats him up. But I'm not sure that's enough safety. Ryu's here. Has to flash in there. Looks for Gate. Locks him down. He's gonna get the support. The chains maybe enough to get Froggen out of the way. Inori trying to chase him down as Ryu will take out the Tom Kench. P1. Nice defense there. And Fox, not too sure about the Baron call there.
It was mostly to get the teleport out of Zig, I would assume. Like,
ooh,
control ward right there.
Looper, very nice. Looking to lock one down.
Arrow
does have his ulti. He needs to kind of make it happen. Use that at the last minute as Arrow hooking himself ultied up by Nautilus. Zig here as well to cover. Now going to move back in. There's a shutdown though for Keith as he takes down Lissandra. And now Arrow kind of getting jumped away. Arcadian doing a ton of damage. And Inori jumps in as well to zone away Froggen. And Arcadian gets his way out. No, Arrow snipes him on the other end.
Froggen has to try to find a way to kill Arrow when he's building magic resistance now too.
Yeah, credit to Zig again as Ryu actually getting himself chased here. Inori is the bait. Arcadian locked down, but Looper with a nice hook forces Ryu's ultimate. Inori going to try and get it down, but they're looking for something. Zig could run problems. Now he's going to try and zone them away. Keith just hitting him. That's not doing anything as Arcadian locked down there as well. Looper taking a decent amount of damage, but Arcadian wants into the backline. He'll get them down, and Zig is
doing
everything. Froggen though, dives to the back and takes out Adrian, takes out Ryu as well. And they're going to lock down Zig. Echo Fox, turn it all around. There's a triple kill for Froggen.
And that's going to be the Baron on top of
it. There's the ulti. He's gonna start it. Ooh, Scry's Bloom. Doesn't go for it once. Froggen is dead. That's a little greedy. He's gonna get chained up here. Nice W to get out from under the first root. Jin though locks him down, and Echo Fox should be able to get this Baron. Inori just can't get back in now.
Yeah, that's enough damage to actually dissuade him, and they're following him all around the map. And Echo Fox back in the lead.
And we talked about it.
Walk or the Lissandra.
It was Zig. They found Keeper. Gate eats him. That's good, but the teleport's coming in from Looper. Tidal Wave, who's going to keep moving through. And Gate taking a good chunk of damage. Arcadian in there as well. As Ryu's going to get knocked up, and Zig goes into the air as well. Adrian eating damage. Froggen looking for another flank. He's found his way around. He needs to go back in, but gets himself exhausted. Keith goes down as Inori. Not able to take him down. Ryu just launches himself into the team. Arrow's going to get the shutdown, and P1 looking to clean up the team fight. Looper sniped down there as well for his GA. Arcadian's got one, but he doesn't have it for long. Arrow is going to flash his way back towards him, and that's three kills already. Make it four as Looper goes down.
That's up huge in that team fight.
We talked about it being one big moment to open things up. This inhibitor's gonna fall on P1 on time. They're gonna rush in and try and finish the game.
Barely any wave clear. They have a lot of damage with multiple AD characters here. The TP coming through as well. Acadian's gonna try to stop it.
Gotta do something, but it's not quite enough. Adrian's still alive, and Acadian doing what he can. Gate moves his way back in, but Acadian gets locked down. Adrian does fall on the other side, and Gate's there.
Keith with one swing, and hold on.
We're at it again. Gate locked up, and he's looking to go down. Keith's up, and Z's on top of him. That's gonna be a crushing takedown as Ryu actually goes down on the other side. Keith lives for a little while longer. His arrow's still firing away. Frogger down for the double as Z takes that one down. Rek'Sai zooms out of the fight as Gate's gonna get himself chased. Annoying now dominating, gets another, and Looper just can't get out here. The wave's down as well, and there's another four kills for P1.
And that most likely is game here with P1 having no inhibitor in this lane. They're gonna try to go for the win.
They are gonna go for it here, and Acadian is trapped all the way back into the top lane. Inori just straight onto it, gonna sacrifice himself for a bit of extra damage here. He's got a GA, he can live for a little while longer, and P1, they're gonna see what they can do. Inori's still tanking, it does go down, and Acadian, he just can't get in. Phoenix One, gonna turn the arrows towards the Nexus and take it down. Back-to-back fight, and a great game one.
A turbulent game, but P1 come out on top.
Singed, of course, is a champion that we haven't seen too much of, but seen a little bit, particularly with all the tanks. Froggen going to be very solid on the Anivia, but it's not a standout mid lane. That thought for now is Inori's popped himself over the wall. Looper locked down by Zig, and this looks like first blood, potentially. Arcadian shadowing around his own. Inori commits for it. Now Arcadian going to move his way back through. Damage is there. That's going to force the flash from Kha'Zix. And now Zig still getting chased down. Arcadian wants it. He's got the flash. Inori doesn't have his, so another Proseek is going to do it. He's going to keep chasing, and he sees, and he flashes it. Looks for the auto, and there's the first blood.
Acadian again, both games, first blood here. We'll see. It's hard to gank a Maokai with flash, but we'll see right here.
Looks like a proxy, but it could just be a gank. Acadian going to try and make it happen. Looper moves his way out, takes one more turret, and it gets
him.
Kill.
Oh, and those Dark Seals, two across the board.
Very slight item advantage, the dagger.
It's a good lane advantage as well. Just in terms of matchup, but hold on, Gate flashing forward.
Blocks there as well. He's low, but they know Acadian's coming. Arrow, he's gonna move in as hook onto Adrian. Teleport's coming in, but Looper, he's there first this time. Arrow, now gonna get locked down. Acadian's gonna try and take him out. They will get one, and now Looper once more. Zigno is joining in as he's gonna lock up Looper. Looper, not that tanky, he's gonna get taken down. Acadian gets out from under the tether, and it's a one for one.
Yep, the one push up because he wants to catch the wave here, and they're throwing three people at Zig.
So the trap here flips, he's gonna land in. Zig's gonna flash Acadian, follows for the knockup. There's a knockback there for Zig, but Froggen's gonna try and cut him off. He's got the flash, they might just dive. Looper gonna start taking up the turret. Damage is starting to come in. Great wall from Froggen. Zig dodges the first E, but the stun's gonna move, and he gets flipped again. And that's an easy kill. Froggen this time gets it.
And they don't get much on the other side of the map for Phoenix One. They have to shove in mid lane and bottom side.
You don't have equal weights on team fights. This is a dive. Arrow's gonna miss. This Keith flashes it. Nice arrow onto Inori, but dive still in. Adrian gets the kill this time. P1 even gonna commit the teleport. Might try for a push here as Looper's also win. It's 2v4 as Keith hooks Zig in towards the turret. He gets played back in, and now he gets flipped back so far towards the turret as Ryu's trying to save his teammate Zig. Tanking up to deliver the good walls there. Might actually not be enough. Great ulti there as Froggen's gonna get egged. And P1 gonna
go
move back in, but Looper wants back in. Arcadia moves in.
Bouncy
Castle triple play. Gonna turn it all around, and now Looper gonna put down the goop, force out Ryu's flash. That was a wonderful turnaround.
Yeah.
Almost two shots him with a bit of help from Thunderlords, but the Infernal Drake, we're gonna go over here to Echo Fox. He's gonna try and stop him, but Arrow as well. Hooked in there, and Froggen's gonna take him down. Ryu with a beautiful ulti, gonna turn around, but Froggen is gonna pop this on his Inori.
Inori in the back.
Again, and he's actually flanked perfectly. Froggen turned into an Aegis. He's gonna go down. P1 again, go off in this fight. They turn around, the Drake goes to Fox, but that means nothing. His Acadian's shut down as well.
A huge turnaround, and the Baron is also on the table here. Looper.
Nope, he's completely turned around now. They'll get the gold lead, they'll take the Baron. And Echo Fox, that was a hard punish for one little Drake.
Oh yeah, and that was
the worst thing, but this Baron's gonna be tough for Echo Fox to clean up. And Anivia's got good wave clear, but there's a nice shockwave again. Acadian always sniped out, that's a kill. Ryu, barely enough damage. He gets himself arrowed. But he balls out there, gonna protect himself with the shields with a bit
behind them that Looper could possibly TP to, but Froggen.
Chunked out again, Adrian Hook, but that's not enough. Good big shield. They're actually diving in for it. Teleport under the top, but it's got Gate. He's already down, and that TP is just going to move in. Looper can't do anything as that turret falls on P1. Breaks straight through the middle. Looper caught down now as well. Not nearly tanking enough through that, and P1, the train's still going.
And there's so much damage here between the three members of Inori, Ryu, and and also Arrow on top of it, and they're gonna try to push here. Froggen, he does have the ultimate to just clear out. So hard to siege against Zenivia, but they have the Baron buff. They have a lot of damage. Zig is tanky if he wants to tank.
Oh, Froggen! Great!
Zig's gonna wait for it.
He's going for it. He goes Froggen! Arrow takes him down. Arcadian get a full here as well. Inori straight to the back lines, ripping people to pieces. Gate can flame into the laser. No, not quite, as his team protects him. And P1, they'll plow through Echo Fox. They'll take down the turrets, and they're gonna try and end this one.
At P1, amazing performance, both from comebacks here. Game 1 and Game 2. There's one for the road, and they're going to take it.
Looper barely respawns in time to see his team get aced. The Nexus open and bare as Phoenix One sweep through Echo Fox for their first game of the year.
Oh, Nori jumps in. No fantasy for you. Crazy performance there, and you can see the sigh of relief from Phoenix One playing from behind at the start, but they're team fighting.